Gather today as the body of Christ on the first Sunday of Lent. In today's gospel, Jesus was tempted by Satan in the desert. Please stand.
Good morning to all of you. Let us begin this celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In today's gospel, my dear friends, Jesus proclaims, "This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel." Now let us take a little time, my dear friends, before we celebrate this Eucharist of love. How often we admit our failures and asking for forgiveness from God and from others. If not, let us pray for the strength to admit our own failures and asking for forgiveness and build the broken relationships. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, through the yearly observance of Holy Lent, we may grow in understanding of the riches hidden in Christ, and by worthy conduct pursue their effects. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God Almighty, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "See, I am now establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, all the birds and the various tame and wild animals that were there that were with you and came out of the ark. I will establish my covenant with you that never again shall all bodily creatures be destroyed by the waters of a flood. There shall not be another flood to devastate the earth." God added, "This is the sign that I am giving for all ages to come, of the covenant between me and you and every living creature with you. I set my bow in the clouds to serve as a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow appears in the clouds, I will recall the covenant I have made between me and you and all living beings, so that the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all mortal beings." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To you, gently leading the poor and the humble. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. To you, I lift my soul. To the ones who see. God will always be
will show them mercy. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. To you, I lift my
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, Christ suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of unrighteousness, of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. In it, he also went to preach to the spirits in prison who had been once disobedient, while God patiently waited in the days of Noah during the building of the ark, in which a few persons, eight in all, were saved through water. This prefigured baptism, which saves you now. It is not a removal of dirt from the body, but an appeal to God for a clear conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers subject to him. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. The Spirit drove Jesus out into the desert, and he remained in the desert for 40 days and was tempted by Satan. And he was among the wild beasts, and the angels ministered to him. After John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. The gospel of the Lord. In the first Sunday of Lent, the gospel invites us in the theme of repenting and believing in the gospel, because this is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. And Jesus also showed us the way that how to do and how to prepare for the Easter festival during the time of Lent. And he went 40 days in the desert and prayed. And after that, he gave this only very brief message. And all his life is all about this, making the people to repent and believe in his gospel message. However, It is always difficult for us in our spiritual life asking for forgiveness. Repenting for our failure is always one of the challenges we all face. Let us go back to all the way to the Adam and Eve. What happened when they failed? When God appeared to Eve, said, "And did you eat the fruit of the forbidden tree?" And she didn't accept that, "I did it." Nope. And she said, God went to Adam and asked this, and when he didn't admit his own failures, all he did is, "The woman you gave to me made me to do the sin." So finally he blamed God himself, because the woman you gave me made me to sin. And when he went to Eve, and she said, "No, I didn't do it. The serpent cheated me." It's always we blaming on some other people, even in your normal language. If a glass is broken, what do you say? "The glass broke." So we don't use the passive sentence, "The glass is broken." No, the glass broke. And we always, because we don't want to take the blame of anything, and we don't want to accept our own failures. Even in our relationship with other people, starting from your spouses, your children, our parents, you know, family, extended family members, why there's a lot of misunderstanding? Just because we train to defend ourselves. "I didn't do anything wrong. I didn't do anything wrong. We always train to tell other people that "I didn't do anything wrong." But the time of fulfillment comes to us, the kingdom of God is come to us, when we are able to have the courage to say, "I'm sorry, I made a mistake." The spiritual life always, my dear friends, begins in admitting our own failures. Let us always understand the truth. All of us are human beings. We tend to fail, and we will fail, and we have failed. Is anyone here without any failures, without any sins? Nobody. Nobody. Everyone. Everyone as a human being, we commit sins. But that is not the end of our life. But Jesus says there's a beginning. And if you and I were to repent for our failures, the time of fulfillment begins. The kingdom of God is at hand here when we are able to say that "I made a mistake," when we are able to admit that we made a mistake and we committed our sins. And repenting always builds a relationship back. The repenting always rebuilds our relationship. And that's what happened. And Adam and Eve, they failed. Then because of their failure, because of what? They were filled with pride. And they could not admit their failures. And because of the pride, they lost the paradise. Then Christ came, as St. Paul explains to us right in the Philippians, that though Jesus was in the form of God, he did not find equality with God, but he humbled himself to be born as a human being and die on the cross. And because of that humility, God elevated him to the level of God, to the highest level. Yes, my dear friends, the pride of Adam made us to lose the paradise. The paradise was lost because of the pride of Adam and because of our pride. When I say Adam, not Adam and Eve, also, we include in that. Because of the pride, we lost our paradise. And because of the humility of Jesus Christ, we are able to regain the paradise. So humility is the key that opens the door of all the virtues. Humility is the way that we can win the people's heart. Not with the pride, not with the argument. And when we are able to admit our own failures in front of others, in front of your family members, in front of your spouses, in front of your children, in front of your whoever that may be, when we are able to admit our failures, the broken relationship is rebuilt. And the time of fulfillment begins. And the kingdom of God is at hand. It is your hand and my hand, my dear friends. Let us all have the greatest courage to say, I am sorry, I made a mistake. Amen. The courage to admit our failures and our sins and to repent for our sins always comes from the faith we have in God. So let us express that faith. I believe in God. In today's first reading, we heard of how God first established a covenant with the earthly following with the great flood. Confident in God's promise that never fails and He never forgets His covenant, let us bring the needs of ours before Him.
For our religious leaders, may they renounce every temptation of power and gratification in favor of the cross of Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations, together may they commit themselves to the preservation of the environment and protection of endangered species, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For victims of violent crimes and their assailants, may the grace of God bring about repentance, reconciliation, and peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered here, as we journey with those in our archdiocese who are preparing for full initiation into the church, may we always strive to live as children of the light, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who suffer illness or injury, may they find healing and hope in God's abundant love, especially Russell Layton, Mark Hasty, Marge Johnson, and Marie Tiffin, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our loved ones who have died, especially Doug and Etta Fino, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us also pray for the safety of all the law enforcement officers and all the two officers and the paramedics killed in Burnsville last night, that God will be a source of consolation, and also there will be end of violence in the streets. Let us pray to the Lord. God of creation, you are the source of salvation and fount of living water that calls us to new life. Hear our prayers that in this season of Lent, we may be cleansed, purified, and have a strength to admit our own failures and repent and bring the kingdom of God at hand. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
With delight, God will turn to you.
Pray, my friends, that a sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the rocks of sacrifice. Give us the right disposition, O Lord, we pray, to make these offerings, for with them we celebrate the beginning of this venerable and sacred time through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God. By abstaining 40 long days from earthly food, he consecrated through his fast the model of our Lenten observance, and by our overturning all snares of ancient serpent, he taught us to cast out the leaven of malice, so that, celebrating worthily the Paschal mystery, we might pass over at last to the eternal Paschal feast. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without the end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly in his passion. He took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life, this chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring us to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, Bernard our Bishop, and all the clergy and all of us gathered here before this altar today. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection and all have died in your mercy, especially Doug and Edna, for whom this mass be offered, and also all those people whom we remember now. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Let us pray with the confidence to our Heavenly Father in the words our Lord Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will. You live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer one another a sign of peace and love. Behold Jesus Christ, who comes to us today to give us the strength and the courage to admit our own failures and asking for forgiveness. Happy are called to his banquet. Lord, may the body and blood of Christ bring us life everlasting.
Shadows of life cloud our view. Feed us and guide us. Surely you alone refine us. You give us grace for lives made new. Forging through your fire and radiance, a sacrifice worthy for you. Feed us and guide us, merciful God. Light when the shadows of life cloud our view. Feed us and guide us, merciful God. People who hunger for you.
Let us pray. Renewed now with the heavenly bread, by which faith is nourished, hope increased, and charity strengthened, we pray, O Lord, that we may learn to hunger for Christ, the true living bread, and striving to live every word which proceeds from your mouth, giving us strength to repent. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. There's just one announcement. Stations of the Cross will be held each Friday of Lent at noon.
Thank you, Paula. And of course, reinforce the announcement. Last Friday, we had only 6 people, including me. So we need more people coming and doing little extra prayers during the time of Lent. We do have on Tuesdays and adoration at 5 p.m. and the Mass at 6 p.m. on every Tuesday. And you could come, make an effort to spend a little time with Jesus and 1 hour on Tuesdays in the adoration at 5 p.m. And also on Fridays at noon, more people can come and meditate upon the Station of the Cross. So it's an opportunity to pray. So this Lent is time of prayer, fasting, and also try to help one another by almsgiving, you know, spiritual gifts. And the last 2 days, yesterday and today, we had this, we have a great event here. Lopet Foundation have this skiing. And we thought that we are going to have too many people parking here, but we did not. But of course, we were prepared. And I thank the gentlemen who operationers who volunteered and Knights of Columbus volunteered very much yesterday and today. They were standing in the cold, and my warm thanks to them. And thank you very much, gentlemen, for being there and helping parking, use our parking lot. And please be seated. Any birthdays today? Please be seated. Any birthdays this week? Okay, one, wow, okay. That's what Kirk said, get up. And Char, and okay, thank you very much. So give them, stand up and let them give them a hand. Like Char, stand up. Okay, good. Give them a hand, yeah. Thank you, happy birthday, and happy birthday. And I don't ask you how old you are. So I will say you'll be sweet 17, yes. Wonderful, and keep up there. Any anniversaries, wedding anniversaries? Nobody gets married in the London time, right? Good, let us stand together to pray. Let us bow our heads and pray for God's special blessing. May bountiful blessing, O Lord, we pray, come down upon your people gathered here today, that hope may grow in tribulation, virtue be strengthened in temptation, and eternal redemption be assured through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice day.
River of glory, springs of harbor, blood of God's riches, poured on the earth. We are born from the darkness and clothed in the light. We are bathed in the glory of God. Fountain of mercy, grace flowing.